Hi there. Thanks for coming and watching my newest video on watercolor painting. I'm using Blick's watercolor studio 9x12, 140 pounds paper. I'm going to first wet the paper with water and a flat brush. I have already outlined my drawing. It is little fishies and larger fishies. I'm using different palettes of watercolor. So first I'm going to just start with the blue because I was attracted to the blue and lightly wash across the paper. And then once I've added my blue, I will add my next layer of color until I cover the whole watercolor paper canvas with my colors of choice. I'm doing like a rainbow color, so after the green I did add a lighter green, and I added the red and the orange and the yellow above and below. These are some of the brushes and the paint palettes that I've been using. If you have any questions about the paintbrushes in detail, I can list them below. And here I am again, just adding my orangey colors above the red, and then I'm going to add the yellow. This watercolor is the koi set, the little white box. It's very easy to take with you for traveling. The paintbrush is actually a travel paintbrush that I love to use. Here you see me adding the limey green color and just slowly stroking back and forth the paintbrush to spread it. Just a thin layer, because when that dries, we will be adding another layer on top of that. It will be the black watercolor. See, I start by adding the black to the canvas. And when I say canvas, this is watercolor paper, like I said earlier. And if you make puddles and it's uneven, don't worry, because it's going to be layered with a second coat of black, unless you like it to be that. I wanted to have a little more black shading. And then I do not paint the fish itself, because that I want to have exposed with all the different colors you'll see. So right here, I'm just going around the outline carefully, enjoying it and taking a deep breath. Now in between layers, I don't know if you know this, but it's, unless you want it to have a wash look, I let it dry. And this is the first layer of black. Then I use the blow dryer to speed up the process a bit, and it does work very well. So now I'm adding my second layer of black watercolor paint, and you see how it's getting darker now. And there is uneven layers, but that's fine, because at the end I do go over it with a lot of detail with my Uni-ball white gel pen. I think this is a gel pen. And it's a lot of fun. You can add any kind of designs to the fish after. I'm using a very thin paintbrush for detail. That's actually the Winsor Newton 1 Series 233. So on each fish, I just wanted them to be a little different. And I added different colors to each fish, whether it be the gills or the tail or the mouth. And then I go back in and I added some more details with black. And I just thought it would be fun to outline the fishies with black so that they'll stand out from the background black. And you see here, I'm adding the white details with the Uni-ball white pen. This is the Signo pen, and now I decided to do little bubbles and little dot bubbles and stars, closed and empty, and then little swishy lines and little florals. There's so many different designs you could do. These were the ones that kind of came to me as I was working. This little pattern I'm really crazy about. I've used it a lot in my art, whether it be a fish looking paisley design. And this is the completed version. I had taped it down so that it wouldn't buckle, and now I'm unpeeling. Oh, a little pull there, but no worries, slowly pulling it off. And I have a piece of glass that I use for when I am painting watercolor. This is washi tape that I used, very thin, and it's a lot of fun unpeeling. It's like, but I also was nervous that I'd rip it a little on the other side, but it was successful. And here's the finishing touch. I hope you enjoyed. Please ask any questions you'd like, or just enjoy the view. And happy fishing, or happy dreaming of fun fishy tales during these winter months. I know I can't wait for warmer weather. We have had some chilly days recently and rainy days, so this brightened up my mood. Thank you, and have a great day. Having any questions about the products or my process, please ask away. Have a wonderful day. Namaste.